afternoon to everybody. Delighted to have Ron here with me. He's been here three times as a manager with Manchester United, Sheffield Wednesday, and two seasons ago as a winner with Aston Villa. But it's good to have him up here with me now on this terrific occasion. The pre-match entertainment has been quite superb. The fireworks, as you saw when the players came out, there are just as many fireworks in the 90 minutes that follow. It is the people's final, this. Something like 34,000 tickets go to each set of fans. 36th League Cup final to be played, and the 30th to be played here at Wembley Stadium. And our guest of honour now coming out is the Right Honourable Virginia Bottomley, Secretary of State for National Heritage, who's the chief guest today and certainly well wrapped up. It's turned after quite a pleasant morning into quite a bleak afternoon. A word there for the young Leeds United mascot, with Gary McAllister alongside him. Gordon McCaig, the president of the Football League, also there. There's big John Lukic, the goalkeeper. And Lucas Radebe from South Africa. Also accompanying Mrs. Bottomley would be the president of Coca-Cola Northwest Europe, Gavin Darby, and David Dent, secretary of the Football League, Carlton Palmer there. Still one or two Wembley appearances. Harry Kelly, the young Irish fullback. And there's Tony Yeboah from Ghana. In Europe awaiting. There's young Andy Gray, just 18 years old. My goodness, doesn't he look like his dad, Frank Gray? Brian Dean, one of the substitutes. He might have thought after his two goals against Everton last weekend that he might be in the starting lineup. Not so. Nigel Worthington, another of the substitutes. Thomas Brolin, the other substitute, Swedish international. No goalkeeper, you'll notice, amongst the Leeds United substitutes today. Howard Wilkinson, he's taken a gamble on young Andy Gray. A gamble, too, on no goalkeeper amongst the substitutes. But he's an assured man who's had 8 years at Leeds United, and he certainly knows what he's about. Andy Townsend. Far cry from those days when he played at Reading and Weymouth. Lad born in Maidstone, the goalkeeper, Mark Bosnich. Tommy Johnson there, who is so near to being fit. Well, you know all these players so well, Ron, and what their temperament is and how they'll be feeling now.
That lad there, Hugo, won't be feeling a thing. He is as strong-minded a lad as I've ever met in my life.
There's Milosevic, whose English, I'm told, is improving, but whether it's good enough for this, I don't know. Came from Partizan of Belgrade. Ian Taylor's got a big part to play in midfield.
I think the lads might appreciate it if the lady hurried on a little bit, you know, getting back to what Jack was saying before the game.
Gareth Southgate with a word there.
Mrs. Bottomley spending an awful lot of time with each player, but I think then the players are more focused on what the job in hand.
Harry Charles, a fullback, been here before with Nottingham Forest. Yeah, I think the players probably prefer it when they just zap down the line and good luck and the rest of it.
Tell you what, has been nice in recent years.
And Dwight, Yorke there.
Oh, yeah.
Ron?
Yeah, he'll love it. He'll love it, yeah. He'll enjoy every moment.
People write to me and say his smile lights up the whole of football, and you can see just what they mean. He certainly had plenty to smile about this season. And Michael Oakes, the reserve goalkeeper furthest there at the other side of Steve Staunton. His dad, Alan Oakes, of course, played here for Manchester City. You were going to tell me something then.
Just trying to think what it was, Brian, at the time, actually. No, I was thinking that they've had a recent trend, haven't they, like when we were here, Nat Loftus was presenting. I think that's terrific, you know, when they have sort of the legends doing it. Stanley Matthews has done it, hasn't he?
Ryan Little there, and then the referee, Robbie Hart of Darlington, 48 years old. It's his last season on the list. Taking rather a long time, this. There's two linesmen, Brian Poddington of Sheffield and Martin Sims, and reserve official Jim Rushton of Stoke-on-Trent. Now we go the national anthem. Get stretched now, and their first job is just to remind you of the lineups. Villa with that settled look about them. They'll play a game with three centre backs, Southgate, McGrath, and Ekiol, and expect the full backs Charles and Wright to storm quickly into opposing territory. Three in the midfield, and then the combination of Milošević and Yorke in attack, which has worked so well for Villa. Manager Brian Little there, what about his preparations?
Tried to worry about the whole week about making sure all the preparations right, making sure the players are okay. I think a little bit more worried than you would do as a player. Everything's there for you, but it's still a sort of day that you'd want to be involved in, even though there's a lot of hassles, you know what I mean? And you believe me, there are a lot of hassles coming to a place like this today. I mean, the last week has just been one thing after another, but it's it lets you know you're in a big game for sure.
United, they've gambled. 18-year-old Andy Gray comes into their attack alongside Yeboah. They also have three centre-backs today, Redivi, Pemberton and Weatherall, with Palmer going into the midfield, and Speed, who fractured a cheekbone only 31 days ago, plays as a forward-looking left-back. Here's the Leeds manager, Howard Wilkinson, in a positive mood.
Well, obviously it's a tremendous occasion, but you know, on the middle it just says winners and runners-up. You don't want that one that says runners-up on it. Don't say anything else, played well or whatever, it just says winners. So now we're here, let's get on with winning.
Well, we've seen Robbie Hart of Darlington, the referee. That, incidentally, is a sneak preview of the kit referees will be wearing in the league next season. Harry McAllister there, ready for the handshake. Subs then for Villa, Steve Staunton, Michael Oakes, the goalkeeper, and Tommy Johnson. Three outfield players for Leeds, Brian Dean, a striker, Thomas Brolin, who can flit around and score the goal or two, and Nigel Worthington, normally playing somewhere around the left-back area. So many of the critics have been saying, Ron, that the quality of this game will depend entirely upon the mental attitude of Leeds United. If they're coming here to play and to entertain, then it'll be a terrific final. If they come here with rather negative thoughts, then it won't be. My feeling is that they'll come here. Very interesting to hear Howard Wilkinson saying, we're here to win.
Yeah, they're here to win. I think if they can win and entertain, Howard would love that. But first and foremost, we know what Howard's like. We've seen his team. He's picked a mirror image of the Villa team, I think. He's looked at cancelling out their strengths. And I think Howard's, if, as I say, if it's entertaining, good. He's come to win. If it means sort of scraping a 1-0 victory, he'll take that.
Well, there's a match winner. Tony Yeboah, £3.4 million he costs from Eintracht Frankfurt. Scored in both legs of the semi-finals against Birmingham City. And really has a patent on the most spectacular of goals.
I was very surprised. You know, look, we've just seen the two strikers, Dwight and Tony Yeboah. I think they're going to be, have very, very few chances today. I think there's going to be an awful lot of, if you like, war of attritions going on in midfield. Certainly in the wide areas, speed against Charles, who's going to win that battle. On the other side, Gary Kelly against Alan Wright. You know, that's a stifling system. And whoever wins those battles is going to go a major part towards winning the game.
Well, here's a man who may not have thought he was playing a couple of 3 weeks ago when he fractured his cheekbone in a cup tie against Port Vale, Gary Speed. And here's Savo Milošević, his first season at Villa, and he's worked up a terrific following there at Villa Park. He's never scored in a Coca-Cola Cup game, as Savo Milošević. He's taken a brunt of a good deal of criticism for some of the misses that he makes, and so often in high-profile games, it seems, on television. Well, he may have the answer for everybody today. Still only 22 years old. Dwight Yorke still only 24 years old. And away we go. The Coca-Cola Cup final of 1996. Villa in the claret and blue. Here's Gary Charles for them. Pumping it forward again towards Dwight Yorke. And there was a foul there by Pemberton on Yorke in the opening seconds. And a free kick to Aston Villa. Townsend behind this. Draper behind it. Heckled up from the back. Milošević will be one that they look for. McGrath's up from the back as well. But Villa get it away, or rather Leeds get it away quite comfortably. Dinklin again, nicely there, this. An offside flag up against Dwight Yorke. And quite clearly offside. A game today that generates something like £2.5 million in gate receipts. Again, Draper, good break from the midfield here, and Villa are up in strength as well. There are four up, but Draper being forced wide there by some good tracking by Carlton Palmer. But Villa's throw, Charles with it, Milošević, Draper, Townsend, Speed defending, another throw for Villa. Charles with a throw, finding Yorke, getting some support from Townsend in there. Yorke with a chance to just play it to Milošević. No power, no problem. A comfortable early touch for Lukic.
Villa look to be brimming with confidence at the moment, Brian. Nice and bright. One or two good little passing movements. A very sharp little throw in there that really bore dividends for them.
McAllister in quickly. Was Gary Kelly who was right in there, right amongst the front runners too.
Yeah, the unfortunate thing was he was facing, he had his back to goal. I mean, Gary Kelly is going into uncharted territory there as a natural defender. I think if that had been ahead of him, that would have been a shooting opportunity.
Well, now the action swings to this end, a corner which McAllister will take, and Weatherall's up from the back. Radib is in there too. Yeboah will be a target.
Don't bet against the number 11 speed. He is excellent in
speed.
The air.
Let's look for him as well then. It's a driven one there towards Weatherall. And Townsend in the end gives away a throw.
You can bet your life that Howard Wilkinson has spent hours upon hours this week on his preparation in set situations.
Speed with the throw. And again it's speed to Ford. The speed. Mark Ford again, a nice little ball played for Andy Gray. He's done well, but he's just run it out of play. But the 18-year-old, in fact, Howard Wilkinson was telling me yesterday, don't worry about his temperament, he's quite all right. And I noticed actually, Ron, just but when that corner was being taken a little earlier on, he's... let's have a look at this first, that... there's a corner. That he was actually scrapping with the Villa players. They were trying to hold him up, and he was not going to be intimidated by those Villa defenders.
Well, he's quite a tall young man, isn't he?
Yes.
He showed an excellent awareness then with the movement, and I thought he was a bit unlucky not to get it. He was edged out a little bit by Andy Townsend on that move.
Well, here's a free kick now for Villa, which Mark Draper will take. Yorke's up. Paul McGrath's up again.
Previous one, Dwight Yorke spun right round the back of this into free space.
And it'll be... In fact, there's a flag up for an offside, so it's a free kick to Leeds.
There's menace from both teams, isn't there? I mean,
yes.
when Villa send, like you said, McGrath, Ehihog, Big Taylor can get in there. And Dwight and Milosevic, of course.
Remember, this is the seventh final in this competition for Aston Villa. It equals the record of Liverpool. And if Villa do win today, then their five victories will also match those of Liverpool's. Gray. This is Radebe, South African. It's an excellent ball he slung out there for Gary Kelly, but well, Kelly couldn't quite keep it in.
Don't think I've seen anybody hit a cross-field ball at Wembley since Jimmy Schooler used to hit them. Like he had a three-wood out hitting that one.
Alan Wright with the throw. Milosevic. He's a handful. Don't worry, he's a handful. He'll miss goals, but he'll go on fighting for them. Here's Yeboah. Counted there and beaten beautifully there by Ekiog, and Radebe gets it back to Lukic. Should be no nerves about Lukic. His 17th season as a pro, the Leeds goalkeeper. Won a league title with Arsenal and with Leeds. Here's Milosevic. Radebe having a little hack at him. Townsend. Draper. Milosevic lying just a little bit deeper at the moment. Ford just getting the foot in for a moment. Now Townsend in support for Villa. Southgate. Draper. Kelly looking around.
It's a very, very... slick interchange of play between Draper and Andy Townsend going on at the moment, and it's important for Leeds that McAllister and Carlton Palmer make sure that nobody, well, and Ford, young Ford to that extent, make sure they don't run off the back of them. And a couple of throw-ins, you know, Andy Townsend's lost his marker, and a little bit of more luck could be in a very, very dangerous position.
Well, Howard Wilkinson, who has moved Carlton Palmer out of the back four where he's been playing lately into the midfield. I think all of us felt that maybe he'd be marking Dwight Yorke, but you said before the start, no, he's not going to do that, and he isn't, is he?
No, I think they've got to get him in there to match Villa's energy, which they will obviously do. Young Ford will just sit and prompt. There'll be a big responsibility on McAllister and Palmer to sort of win the battle in there against Draper and Townsend. I did think that he may very well have, Howard may have took a little bit of a gamble and pushed Pemberton, who can do that job, onto Dwight Yorke.
Brian Little, the Aston Villa manager. They've certainly got Villa moving this season again. They're fourth in the Premiership, remember. They have an FA Cup semi-final coming up as well. Lukic. A bit long, McGrath there. Sure, as reliable as ever against Yeboah. Yeboah getting his ball back now to Frankie Gray. Rough to Andy Gray, son of Frankie Gray. Bosnich. And a bit of goal. Fairfield, Australia. Getting it long. Pemberton jumping. Not making a contact. Radebe gets it away. Strong challenge there by McAllister. Looked as though there might have been a bit of elbow leading towards Paul McGrath there.
He said go Gary McAllister there, but he was always trying to make up the ground.
Free kick to Villa, which Southgate will take. Little chip in there towards Ekiog. He took a nudge in the back as well. Draper to Charles. Made in again to Milosevic. Touched by him, didn't come off, but it's four. Kept his cool beautifully in the penalty area and found McAllister with a good pass. And Yeboah's gone streaming on ahead of him. This is a great run by McAllister. And he's got Gray on this side. Yeboah's still waiting in the middle. And Kelly had got up as well, but Cross didn't do justice to the move that had gone on before it.
I think two minds there, Gary Speed. You know, probably didn't see to... I think if Brian Dean had been playing, he'd have just tossed that one in first ball. But I think when it went to him, two minds, is there enough bodies in the box, or shall I cut it back to McAllister, who'd set the whole play up?
Terrific run by McAllister.
Oh, brilliant, brilliant.
Weather all beaten in the air. Pemberton, spare man at the back, Radebe. Taylor, Milosevic. What a battle that's going on there between him and Radebe. Supported there by Andy Gray.
He always gives you a chance of a little bite at the ball, does Savo, because he dwells on it a little bit. He's confident enough to hold it up in midfield, but he does tempt defenders in to have a little rattle, I think. A little bit disturbing how many times Dwight Yorke has beaten Weatherall already in the air.
Yes.
But not only Weatherall, but Weatherall and Radebe.
Here's Yorke again. A little touch on the ground, but there's a foul on a free kick to Leeds United. It's going to be John Pemberton, no? He's going to leave it to Lucas Radebe. In turn, he's going to leave it to John Lukic.
I think from here they've got to somehow to try and get this onto Alan Wright. It's a hell of a long kick, though, because they're strong in that area. This is a test of it. Strong in that air with Hugo and McGrath coming across that side. There's somehow, if they're going to throw high balls, he's offside.
So offside. Flag is up.
There you saw the difference between Yeboah facing a goal, even if it was offside, yes. He latched onto it. When he seems, when he has balls played into him, he's not aware, he's well offside. Unlucky, it would have been a lucky ball for him.
A quick reaction to him.
Yeah.
Strong with the challenge, Gray. Draper. This looks a good break for Villa. Charles. Milosevic is in there. Taylor's in there. Yorke is in there. Palmer's going to make sure it's all academic, though. Oh, and he's giving it away to Draper. Right, Yorke. Drifting wide as he does so dangerously. Townsend. Again, Townsend hitting it long this time, and far too long. Although Taylor might make something of it. Is Kelly in trouble here? Well, he needed some support from Weatherall. Here's Kelly. Southgate cutting it out. Right. Whoa, Andy Townsend in there.
Oh, Andy. Andy, what a touch. I mean, that's a brilliant little layup by Milosevic. A great time run from Andy. I'm not sure whether he felt he... sure that he felt handy then when he was going to try and play Milosevic back in, but
that's the thought that I...
It looked a ball to take through himself, didn't it? I mean, he timed his run to perfection and Milosevic put it right into his path.
Free kick to Leeds. Radebe. And again Radebe. Gary Charles, wasn't a good ball by the defender. That's a better one by Charles. And here's Yorke again, turning well, trying to take Pemberton out of the game. Always causing Pemberton problems here. But then speed coming to support. And gets the ball away towards Gray. Comes again to Dwight Yorke. And Yorke again. Hit Lukic with it. Well, you could say Lukic knew nothing about it, but the one thing you can say also about Lukic is that he stood up really big for that one. Because Yorke surely hit it.
I must admit, when he latches onto this one, Dwight, when he latched onto it, I thought he was going to go across the goal like he did in the game earlier in the season. He's tried, actually. Fair to Lukic, stood his ground well.
Yeboah. But the first real opening of the game. And it fell to Aston Villa. Radebe backpedalling. Yorke is after him. It'll be a goal kick.
He's good at that, Dwight Yorke. He knows that Gary Speed's pushed on. There's the incident. It's rebounded back to him. And I think it's Pemberton has dwelt off him a little bit. He's done well to get the first block.
Yeah.
From there, well, it's good goalkeeping. Stood up, didn't give himself up. But Dwight York's exceptionally good at running the gullies. And he'll run in the space that Gary Speed's leaving. He'll want the ball slid up there all day if he can.
Palmer. Miscontrolled the header, but got back quickly. Then there was an obstruction there by Charles. A free kick to Leeds United. What a waste of a kick. Ugo Ekiog. To Yorke. Taylor's made a terrific break down the left-hand side. Yorke has spotted him. Milosevic in the middle. Townsend's gone up quickly. Wright is supporting from behind. Here's Alan Wright. Taylor again. Yorke. Milosevic. Again, Villa hold him up. And again, McAllister makes the break. And again, he's got support on both sides. This time it's Gray. Kelly's outside him. My goodness, this. What about this for a bit of confidence? Oh, my goodness, a great bit of play there by the 18-year-old.
Oh, that's brilliant. That's an exciting one now.
A note in the manager's handbook. And another look from the other side of the field at this terrific run by 18-year-old Andy Gray.
Oh, good feet. Gareth Southgate doesn't know what that is then. He's got a lot of goal to guard. He's probably leaning forward a little bit. But that's encouraging for him. Because probably he'll come in with really no nerves. Completely. He won't know what it's all about. He'll be uninhibited by that. That's a brilliant sort of
Yeboah.
Exciting one for him.
Kelly. Yesterday, with Howard Wilkinson, he was pondering whether or not to gamble on young Andy Gray. But he was saying, I think I might go with the kid, he said.
It's funny how that can work for you. Now, I remember we did the same 2 years ago with Graham Fenton.
That's right.
Right out of the blue, stuck him in. Hadn't got time to think about it. The lad had a blinder.
But you were saying, you were talking to Carlton Palmer earlier on, you were saying if he plays, he could be the match winner for us.
Yeah. He was very, very optimistic about the lad. He thought he could hold the ball up well and support Yeboah.
Well, here's a corner for Leeds. McAllister with it. Weatherall wants it. Radebe is in there. Gray's in there. Yeboah, of course, is there. Speed is there as well. Good catch.
Well, that's a positive one. He's come close on 18 yards to take that, and he's climbed above a lot of big people.
Milošević.
See the winning aerial balls now. You wouldn't expect David Weatherall to lose balls in the air against people.
But here's McAllister. First time he's played in a cup final of any sort here. Milošević. That one, the tackle was bound to come in. Draper. Charles. There's Yorke. Redibi with him. Charles with the cross. Lukic.
Great link up play. They're getting it into York's feet early and he's linking the play up terrific. I mean, that was superb link up play between Charles and Yorke.
Here's Tony Yeboah into the path of McAllister. Trying to get Andy Gray on the far side. He's got support from Kelly.
A lot more fluency about the Villa play. They're more compact. They're playing shorter, quick one and two touch passing with a lot of mobility. Leeds at the moment, I think, are prepared to say, all right, we'll play on very much a counter and leave a lot to the two front players, sometimes supported by McAllister.
Free kick to Leeds. Ladbrokes, in fact, making Villa 5-4 favourites. Leeds 2-1. 2-1 the draw. First to score, they couldn't separate Dwight Yorke and Tony Yeboah, each at 4-1.
I think we were having a little thought about the quirks of football. A famous old Villa name, Andy Gray.
Yes. Well, here's Villa with another attack. Savo Milošević. Oh, a terrific goal! A fantastic goal by Milošević. The 22-year-old from Partizan Belgrade, who's been the butt of a few jokes this season because Milošević, they called him. Well, he didn't miss this one. He saved the best shot of all for the biggest stage of all. And Aston Villa are 1-0 ahead through Savo Milošević.
Phenomenal strike. Full credit to Taylor. Ian Taylor made a great run from the side to occupy defenders. But I think Howard Wilkinson will be very unhappy with Pemberton. Pemberton backed off and backed off and backed off. Everybody knows Savo is a left-footed player. He should have been closing down the left-hand side and getting closer to him. The full credit, great strike. But look, there's the run. The run takes Weatherall in field. Now he's gone.
That is a phenomenal strike.
Great strike. But that's when you expect your defender to say, hey, he's in the zone, he's in the danger zone. Got to clean that one out.
That's his first ever goal in the Coca-Cola Cup. And he's chosen Wembley to score it.
But in all fairness, Brian, I think Villa have dominated the proceedings so far. I mean, they've settled into the game. And I think they've caused the back three of Leeds a lot of problems.
Speed to McAllister. To Palmer. And Wright gets it away. Up to Milošević. A lot of credit actually to the Villa backroom staff under Brian Little. They've stuck with Milošević even though chances were going away. They felt there was something about Milošević that would be good for Aston Villa. And that certainly has prospered now. Townsend.
To be fair, at the moment they're threatening to run riot.
Sorry?
Villa are threatening to run riot at the moment. Far slicker than the passing, compact as a team. And at the moment, in many ways, Leeds are chasing shadows.
I mean, he's taken some stick this season, Milošević, from critics all around the place, from us included.
He scored 14 goals.
And he scored 14 goals.
Or something like that, at least 14, isn't it?
Well, I read somewhere this morning he couldn't hit a cow's backside with a banjo. Well, I tell you what, he's hit the back of a net with alacrity today.
He hit it five times against us already.
Yeboah, good ball. Oh, and McAllister tried so hard to get it into Palmer. Yorke. Bannister, and it falls for Townsend. Milosevic is in there again! But he was very well tracked indeed there by Weatherall. And have a look at Milosevic's goal again. Onto that left foot of his. A terrific strike. Villa 1-0. Villa's corner, which Draper will take, made short to Dwight Yorke, and now for Draper, curled in by him. Southgate's up there but won't reach it. Townsend poorly back in there, and in the end it's a goal kick.
So they're getting pulled all over the place. That's not something we expect to see Leeds having problems with, defending corners.
What do they do, Ron?
Well, I think somehow or other they've got to try and put... They've certainly got to tighten up at the back. I think they've been very, very loose. The back three have been very, very loose with their defending. Allowing Yorke... Every time the ball's played into Yorke and Milosevic, they can accept it and link up the play. So they've got to nullify that to start with. And then they've got to try and get... They've got to try and get Palmer and McAllister higher up the field. At the moment, mainly Leeds midfield has spent the time tracking back, albeit because Villa are pushing them there.
Right to Southgate, the flag has stayed down. This is still Southgate, almost got it through to Milosevic again.
I mean, at the moment, unless they gain some supremacy, all you can see is Villa going on to get another goal.
Well, here's Townsend, Radebe's backing off him. It's still Townsend onto the right foot, and this time Lukic having a very sharp word with his defender, backing off to that extent.
Almost a carbon copy. That's the third time. One cost them a goal. That nearly cost them a goal. And the other one was when the ball hit Lukic on the chest. Whether it's because they're not used to playing this system so much, although they've played it a couple of times against Liverpool recently. I don't know.
Towards Yeboah. McAllister. Kelly. Again. Offside against Palmer.
I mean, I certainly think it's a system that if it continues like this, Howard will dispense with. I think you could put Worthington on as an orthodox left back, pull Kelly into his proper position there, and go a more basic 4-4-2 if you like. Because they're having problems down the sides of them. Everything that's played down the sides of their defence, they're having a problem with.
Milosevic. Getting the better of Weatherall, and then Ford.
Strange. You don't expect to see David Weatherall going on things like that. You expect to see him winning the first ball from the goalkeeper.
Nice turn. Milosevic is there. Quickly challenge. Play on, said the referee.
The other thing Leeds must do, of course, Brian, is they've got to try and keep the score at a minimum as it is, because their turn in the game will come, because Villa players are playing at such a tempo. People like Townsend are here, there and everywhere, and you just wonder whether that could tax them a little bit at some stage.
It's a big pitch, isn't it?
Yeah. But, I mean, if Villa... at the moment, you could see Villa if going on to 2 and 3.
Weatherall gets there first. But Ian Taylor picks it up for Villa. And now Andy Townsend.
He's everywhere this far. Jack was on about before the game what a great player he is, and he's everywhere at the moment, Townsend.
It's a Leeds throw. Not been in a major final, Leeds, remember, since 1973. They were beaten here by Sunderland in the FA Cup final. Yeboah. Well, that ricocheted very conveniently for Carlton Palmer.
Oh, he didn't see it. Carlton should have looked in early. Yeboah had made a great run in field.
Yeboah had just slipped McGrath there, hadn't he? This is Ford making a very good run. But in the end, trying just a bit too much, and Ekiog was there.
There you see the strength of the man.
not only that, look at that for a ball to Dwight Yorke on the far side. Draper's gone through the middle too. It's still with Yorke. Milošević is in the middle. Little Alan Wright's coming quickly as well. And it's gone across the face of the goal for a goal kick.
I mean, that would have been a wonderful goal. Great build of play, mainly through the centre-half of Yorke. As you say, Alan Wright has steamed into the box, a little lane here.
You can see him on the left of the picture there. He's
a little rolling ball, and Dwight and Wright's got a better chance than a penalty. But they're enjoying it. I think that's the big thing at the moment. The Villa team, they're enjoying the occasion and they're enjoying the way they're playing.
Townsend with the corner then for Aston Villa. Well, they had trouble getting that one away. But not that. Straight from Draper. Into the arms of Lukic. Six Aston Villa goal attempts, just one for Leeds United. Charles getting better at speed, puts the ball long, too long. Draper now. He's all backing away. Radebe read that well. Nipped in. Found speed. Quarter of an hour of the first half left. And Yuba and McGrath at odds with each other.
See what your boy's left hand's doing. He doesn't appear to have done anything untoward to Big Macca. I think he's just fallen on him.
Oh, McGrath is being booked.
I wonder whether that's for the retaliation or whether it's for the challenge from behind, which wasn't a particularly violent one, was
it? Not really. A free kick to Leeds, though. McAllister with it. Palmer's in there. But Taylor did a good job, turned in again by Kelly towards Yeboah. And here's Gary Charles. With a header.
To be fair, Kelly did remarkably well, because I thought the Villa defenders were pushing him into an area that wasn't particularly dangerous, and that's a very, very good ball. A bit of luck, that might have just fallen into your bowler's path.
Forward to McAllister. Season Brian Little with Aston Villa, she's saying fourth in the Premiership, FA Cup semi-final, and leading here in the Coca-Cola Cup final by a goal to nil, Savo Milošević the scorer. Watching up in Yorkshire. Well, there's still a long way to go yet. He's also got Brian Dean and Thomas Brolin on the bench. Brolin's certainly a big match player, isn't he?
Very much indeed, yeah. I mean, he hasn't really been a big player since he's been at Leeds, hasn't he? Hasn't done anything like you would have expected him to. Brian Dean. I honestly thought Brian Dean would play today.
Yeah. Oh, it's Milosevic again.
Oh, that's... I mean, the defences are all at sixes and sevens. They haven't a clue at the moment where they are, the Leeds back line.
Do you think they might be tempted to put Palmer back in defence?
No. I think his energy is too vital for them in midfield. I think they will have to have him in midfield. I think the way they'll do it is possibly flattening out into a back four if necessary. I mean, it won't happen for a while. I mean, they'll stick with it like this for a while and, you know, just hope that they can claw their way back into the game.
Weatherall with the clearance up towards Yeboah. Palmer's long legs, Andy Gray's young legs, but Southgate gets there first, finds Mark Bosnich. Heckled with a long ball forward, and here's Milosevic again. Oh, he's gone past Radebe. Milosevic again, and a good challenge that time, and a timely one right at the last ditch there by John Pemberton.
But, I mean, there's no way in the world, Brian, the Leeds defence should have been in trouble from a long ball like that from Hugo Ehi. It's a good ball, but Savo's not the quickest player in the world, yet he's been able to pull it down in a wide area. And as you say, great retrieving tackle. Radebe's having a problem on the left-hand side of defence. A major problem.
Well, it's Draper with the corner. McGrath couldn't get a touch on that. A chance for Leeds to break now. The long legs of Carlton Palmer.
He needs Kelly to run past right here for his pace.
That's what he's done. But Palmer's come inside, he turned around, and by then, Paul McGrath had come back. McAllister, momentum's lost a little bit in this Leeds attack now. But here's Yeboah. And you get the better of Gary Charles. They get a throw.
It's a funny with Tony Yeboah, he never convinces you when he's away from the penalty area. I mean, when he's in the penalty area, obviously, he does convince you, but when he's away from me, even then, you weren't convinced he was going to beat Gary Charles.
Speed. A little chip in. Too high for Andy Gray. Palmer tried to make something of it. McAllister's trying to make something of it. But now it's Milosevic again for Villa. Ian Taylor's up ahead of him. Dwight Yorke is away on the far side. Here's Yorke versus Weatherall. Oh, that's an obstruction that's going to bring about a yellow card for Weatherall. And he really can't argue with that.
You might think his lucky stars that Pemberton was a little bit more central.
Precisely. If he'd been the last defender.
Yeah. So I wonder if they... See what Dwight Yorke is doing while he's pulling out... They've got the three at the back. Dwight Yorke's pulling down the sides of the last defender every time. And he knows he's got too much pace for them all. I'm not so sure that'd be the same if Gary Kelly was in his orthodox right-back position.
Milosevic has got a problem, but a problem that can be solved. Let's hope. There's the free kick. There's the handling again of John Lukic.
That's been a major problem for Leeds, hasn't it? The movement, Yorke particularly, also Milosevic, but the movement down the sides of their three central defenders. I think what you talk about, the defender on the ball side, getting the gully first and preventing the ball getting in there. Leeds haven't done that. They've allowed the Villa front players to receive the ball in those wide areas.
Gray. Radebe. It's a good ball. It's an excellent ball by Radebe. Picked up here by Kelly. Nothing here for Ford. Back again for Palmer. Kelly again. McAllister, nice turn.
That's better, Brian. Put a few passes together so they're compact now.
But McGrath read that beautifully. There was a little trip by Yeboah. I think it was an accidental one, but it was clearly worthy of a free kick on McGrath. Milošević moving smoothly now. But it's a lead throw.
It's also a better challenge from Weatherall that time. He's made sure Milošević hasn't been able to receive and gather the ball and link up the play again.
Winners, remember, going to Europe, into the UEFA Cup next season. It's a real money-spinning payday here for the team that wins. Speed with the head-on. Ah, with the clearance. Oh, a nice little touch there by Milošević, and here's Townsend streaming through, and he's got Draper on that side. Draper looking to get sort of angle, in the end finds Taylor, and now Wright. Draper again. Wright's coming to the middle. Taylor. Draper. Playing like a side that knows all about success. They've been beaten only three times this year, three times in the last 20 games. I think there's going to be a yellow card for Ford.
A lot of that is frustration. He got caught piggy in the middle against the passing triangles. I'm not so sure that's a booking. Not for me. Andy Townsend's quicker to the ball. He's flicked it past him. Andy's not bothered by that.
Townsend on the ball now. Chip. It was intended for Milošević, but it was a way off target. Goal kick to Villa. To Leeds United.
And every time the Villa attack, you get the impression they're going to get in for a goal-scoring chance, don't they? The way the movement and the slick passing. Funnily enough, when Leeds come forward, you don't really get the same belief. You know, they look rock solid there, the Villa, the three in the middle.
McAllister. Yeboah chasing on, Southgate holding him up and doing it well, but Yeboah's got something to answer with yet. Kelly trying to get round Southgate, succeeds in doing so, Yeboah with a header! Two were there, both Gray and Speed, and neither of them frustratingly could just get ahead to that ball, but that was possibly the best chance that Leeds have had so far.
It was. He's done well again here, Kelly. He's been channeled away, looks to have no chance, stands it in. Yeboah, you think, has got a little touch. And to be fair to Charles, he's just done enough to stop Speed flying at that point. I actually wonder whether young Gray was a... You know, whether they anticipated it enough. I thought Gray might have been going in on it as well.
Weatherall's header. Taylor takes it up now for Villa. Draper. Okay.
I mean, anyone. I mean, you're looking at the midfield player. They're just pulling wide into acres of space.
Will take the goal kick again for Leeds United. Went his way back into the side from Mark Beeney in February and has performed really well since then. Alan Wright. Weatherall, that gave Palmer no chance. Yorke. He's done well there. Oh, he's done well there. Townsend keeping it going, but the ball in the end just didn't fall for him, and Kelly had tracked him really well. Gray now back to Pemberton. Driven cross there towards Yeboah. It might just come for Speed, will it? No, because Gary Charles got there first, but it'll be a throw to Leeds United. Leicester. Can Javert get to that one? No, I think the ball might... No, he's done well, he's done brilliantly. But it'll fall for Wright.
He did very, very well. Through ball from McAllister, did very well, Yeboah. But you don't really want Tony Yeboah crossing the ball to, you know, to Kelly.
Offside against Milosevic.
That big man at the back, that effort helps. He's enjoying the contest. Him and McGrath, I think, are thriving on the physical challenge of Tony Yeboah. Because they're both very, very strong themselves. Both strong-minded, both strong physically.
Well, he's been through all the fires, hasn't he? And he's got a couple of dodgy knees that the physio, Jim Walker, works on most of the week. Doesn't do an awful lot of training, Paul, but he does a fantastic amount of playing, and there he is again. Milosevic. As well, Ekiol moving smoothly forward here. Draper with a shot, another goal kick. Right on half time. It's been entertaining enough. That 45 minutes seems to have flown by to me.
You amaze me when you say it's half time, Brian. I think it's been a very, very, particularly from the Villa, I think Villa have been excellent in the first half. Bright, sharp, and lively. If it stays like this till half-time, I think Leeds have had a little bit of a result, to be fair, at this stage, because they've been second so many times, and it does at least give Howard a chance to say, rectify it either tactically or from an attitude... Not an attitude point of view, but from a, if you like, a belief point of view.
Up goes Yeboah. Pemberton. Yeboah beaten by the challenge of McGrath, Palmer, and now Ford. Gets it through to McAllister, through to Palmer again. There are a few white shirts are up there right on half-time. Here's Gary Kelly. Wright trying to force him inside first of all, now trying to get him down that line. And in the end concedes a corner. Super little fullback Alan Wright. He's done really well for Villa this season. Well, it's Gary Speed. Badib is up there. Alistair right on the goal line. Can Leeds bring it level right on half-time? Curled in, McAllister almost got his head to it. In fact, it was the fist of Bosnich just above his head, and a long clearance there by Townsend, and only Milosevic is up. But Draper has come flying forward for Villa. But Radebe, who is a strong-minded man, kept his ground well, kept his head, and more than that, finds McAllister with a good ball. But Villa have got plenty of people back.
Yeah, they hold the attack up well, Villa, defensively. They hold the attack up and get numbers back.
Half-time whistle. What an excellent first half it's been. And capped off by the superlative goal by Milosevic. Back in the commentary box with me, Brian Moore, and Ron Atkinson. And Brian Dean is on then for Leeds United. It's Mark Ford who's gone off. Brian Dean, who scored a couple against Everton last weekend. Oh, that's a better shot. He was Leeds Player of the Year last year. Former Sheffield United man. Villa, as we look around, field, not surprisingly, the same 11. They had much the better of the first half, and Savo Milošević, with that terrific goal, puts them ahead of the game 1-0. Andy Townsend, terrific captain, inspirational motivator, as you can see. You play for him or else. Well, the substitution's just about to be made. John Barnes, what do you make of that one?
Well, I expected Brandon to come on. I think that with Gary Kelly getting some good crosses in, I think that he was kicking himself that he didn't have Dean on, because Dean would have got closer to a few of those crosses. But I think they're looking to bombard the Villa defence now, put some balls in for okay. Brian Dean and Yeboah.
OK, John, thanks a lot. And away we go then, the start of the second half. Goes Paul McGrath. Pemberton. Canister. We've got to be brighter, says Howard Wilkinson. We've got to pass the ball better. And somehow they've got to conjure up a goal.
And they've still got to be able to contain Villa in midfield. I'm just wondering, it looks like Andy Gray's going into a sort of semi-midfield role.
Pemberton. Palmer. Hickey out for Villa. Dean's after him, hasn't had a touch yet. Meanwhile, up at Old Trafford today, Manchester United 1, Tottenham Hotspur 0, a second-half goal by Eric Cantona. United now 3 points clear of Newcastle. Newcastle, though, with 2 games in hand.
Just seen twice in the last 30 seconds the value of Brian Dean. All of a sudden, big Hugo Ehighog, who's been, for me, the dominant defender on the field, has been pressurised twice and hasn't been able to deal with it anything like as comfortably as he did in the first half.
Couldn't get to that one the first time, but he did the second. There's McGrath. Again, as reliable as ever. The ball comes in once again. Weatherall's there with the header, but no problems at all. An easy bounce for Mark Bosnich. Leeds United's throw. In their last 6 games, not exactly overflowing with confidence, but they've certainly made a brighter start to this second half now. Palmer.
I think they've got to be very, very careful that they don't empty midfield too soon, because if they do, Draper and Townsend will cut them to ribbons.
Well, here is Draper now. Milošević has gone wide for him. Here's Milošević. Redwall did well. Charles. Back to Townsend. Yorke. Leeds get it away again, though. Yeboah couldn't get on the end of it. Weatherall got on the end of that. Yeboah chesting it down. No foul. Dwight Yorke has got behind the defence this time. Cross comes in. Oh, it bounced awkwardly there. Ian Taylor, it bounced awkwardly as well for him. Palmer. Hit long towards Dean. McAllister. Great challenge there between McAllister and Townsend, and it's Brian Dean taking it up as the Yorkshire crowds are roaring him on. And he finds Gary Speed. Andy Gray's on the outside. Dean and Yeboah in the middle. And Kelly's in there too, and so too is Bosnich.
I think the biggest single difference Brian Dean has given them is a lot of more, if you like, passion and drive and verve for the game. I mean, at least now McGrath and Ehighog know that they've got a battle on their hands and that somebody to share the load with Yeboah. But there are acres, I keep repeating this, there's acres of space in midfield because McAllister's going to drive on. Gray's not a naturally defensive midfield player, so at the moment Palmer seems to be stuck between about 3 Villa midfield players. We're all very, very good at coming forward.
Dean held up there by Taylor. Speed. He's got a good record, a good goal scoring record in this competition too. Here he is again, Gary Speed, played the ball nicely in for Andy Gray. Oh, he's done well here, Gray, and good work by Bosnich. And there's certainly more of a spark about Leeds in this second half. They've got a corner,
The young lad, on about three or four occasions, John Gray has shown some great feet. I mean, his footwork there was sensational. He's almost tied McGrath up in a reef knot there, coming out of that.
Here comes the corner with Gary McAllister. Leeds' hopes are rising. They've still got to find a goal. Curled in there. Debbie was right in there, but he went the wrong way. Milošević. Oh, McAllister again. They've given it away. McAllister shot charged down. Just listen to those Leeds fans now.
Well, it's taken them a long time, but now they're getting something to cheer a little bit. They're seeing their side driving forward.
Up goes Dwight Yorke, challenging Pemberton. It's Yorke now for Villa. Oh, he's done him beautifully there. There's a little cross towards Milošević again. Townsend's in there too, and somehow Leeds keep them out. Charles. Draper. That's a good ball for Gary Charles. He takes up such good positions there. It's a corner then for Villa. Andy Townsend will take it. Big Paul McGrath's up. Taylor's in there. Milošević. Dwight Yorke on the goal line. Villa looking for that second goal of a cushion. Corner like that. Kelly. Yeboah. This is a break. A big Ghanaian striding forward, but Draper and Wright between them hold him at bay. Weatherall versus York. Weatherall wins that one comfortably enough. Wright. Milošević. Becoming a very good cup final this now, with Villa still leading 1-0. Draper. Milošević. Ekiok. Again. Charles. Touch for Andy Townsend onto the left foot. Long shot, moving a bit in the air, but Lukic had his eyes on it. Oh, that's McGrath clearance, only goes to Andy Gray. And Ekiog holds him up. This is good stuff now.
It's certainly a high-tempo game now. I mean, in the first half, Villa were controlling all the moves. They're dominating play. They're having a good spell at the moment, but to be fair to them, Leeds are at least making a fight of it now. They're driving the game forward a little bit.
Linesman absolutely spot on.
He lost his defender as well. He pulled on Pemberton's shoulder, and Pemberton, in all fairness, didn't really know where Dwight was then. He's the most thankful player on the field to see that flag go up.
Lukic with the kick. Townsend's clearance up to Milošević. A little touch by him to Draper. Forward now to Dwight Yorke. Townsend. Look at the run of Alan Wright here from one side of the field to the other. He's gone. And it's a goal! It's Taylor and it's two.
The result of some good play down the left-hand side between Townsend and a deep cross. I wonder about the goalkeeper here. I just wonder. Probably thought Radebe was going to deal with it, but that's a full volley from Ian Taylor. Couldn't have struck it any better. At one stage, I thought the goalkeeper was going to come and try and claim it. Perhaps that's a bit harsh, but an excellent finish.
And a terrific bit of play there by Alan Wright in the first place. He's all over the field and storming up that left-hand side there. And here come Villa again. This time it's Draper. Yorke. Taylor. Dwight Yorke. It's going to be a hard game for Leeds to pull around now. Milošević. Southgate.
Yeah, they're going to have to dig something out from somewhere, Brian, which in terms of areas, this is the stage where I thought maybe, and I think even the goalkeeper himself had made up his mind to start coming, but that is some strike.
Dean with a header. Yabur with another one. And then one by McAllister. But here's Ekior. Certainly a bright start to this second half by Leeds, but it's all for nothing now. Foul on Milošević. Free kick Villa. Troublesome times now for Leeds United manager. Two are going to be so difficult to pull back. Speed. Sagathley, Southgate hoisting it forward again. Radebe with a header back. Gray. Pemberton. Speed. In for Gray. Pemberton. A little lucky to get away with that, Dean. And the throw to Villa. After him. He finds Ekior. Charles has gone through the middle. Draper. Ekior. Towards Dwight Yorke. Still over half an hour to go. Gray shoves Ekiog out of the way, but gets a throw in the end for Leeds.
I think, but whenever you see a Leeds player with the ball in an attacking position, he's surrounded by claret and blue shirts. It's not quite the same when Villa come forward. They seem to be having a lot of 1v1 confrontations.
Foul there by McAllister on Draper. Free kick to Villa. Davy. Now speed. And now Leeds coming across and coming forward, but McGrath halting Yeboah. Speed with a throw. McAllister, Gray, still back heel. McAllister getting to the byline. Possibilities here for Leeds, but no.
Say it's incredible that the majority of Leeds' best moments or the most threatening moments have come when young Gray's got possession. I mean, that little back heel is terrific nerve.
Good EB. It falls for Dwight Yorke. Villa crowd's looking for something spectacular here. He finds Townsend, and a good strike there by Draper. They're playing some stuff again now, Villa.
Yeah, they're well in control. I mean, long ball up from Bosnich there, the little knockdown, and all of a sudden two support midfield players. Andy Townsend pops it off, and that's about the third good shot that Villa have had that's gone down the keeper's throat. I mean, the scoreline could be absolutely humiliating at the moment.
It stays at 2-0. Southgate with the free kick. You have to whistle loud in this atmosphere, Andy, to make yourself heard. 11 goal attempts by Villa, 5 by Leeds. Up goes Palmer, over his head. Radebe gets it clear. Right, a nice little cushioned header. And here's Townsend in space, looking for Yorke and finding him. Being forced away, though. Yorke again. Draper. Charles is there. Milošević away on the right. It's a Villa throw. Charles, Dwight Yorke, Townsend turning away from trouble, finding support from McGrath. Southgate hitting it long and hitting a good one long there, but speed got back. Thomas Brolin, Swedish international, getting ready to come on for Leeds.
Well, the natural one to come off, you would think, would be young Andy Gray, but that would be, I think he'd be a bit hard done by if he had to come off.
We think it might be Radebe.
What do you think that means then, Brian? Do you think he'll put Palmer at the back, or do you think he'll play speed as a left-sided, a left full-back, if you like? Kelly back to an orthodox position. I think I prefer Kelly back in his normal right full back position.
Yeboah knocking it on. Draper getting it clear. I don't think he'll want to put Palmer back, will he? I think.
I wouldn't have thought so, but I mean, if he's just going to leave the two at the back, he's going to leave acres of space, even more space for Yorke and Milošević to go into.
But he might feel also, Ron, that the horse has almost bolted in any case.
Yeah, but I mean, it still can't. All right, it's OK to say we'll gamble, but I mean, look at the space.
Well, here's the space now for Draper, and he's got Milošević away on the right. It wasn't a good ball. Radebe picked it up comfortably, finds Brian Dean, who in turn finds Carlton Palmer. Southgate lost in two semi-finals for Crystal Palace last season, in the League Cup and in the FA Cup. Levy. Finds Gray. Speed to Dean. Down the line it goes again. Gary Speed, beaten by the challenge of Paul McGrath.
That's the difference in the two sets of central defenders. The Villa trio push over as quickly as a hole develops in wide areas. They push over and cover it very quickly.
It's Rodibi who's gone.
I think this is going to be a very, very interesting team selection. Whether Pemberton's pushing over there and Kelly's coming back to make the third man at the back, I'm not sure. And I don't think the Leeds players are quite sure at the moment.
Rowling obviously came on with a message and gave it to Gary Speed, so maybe it's Speed who's got to drop into the back, into the back line.
Yeah, that's it. Kelly's got, they've flattened out, they've gone forward, they've gone Speed as a left-sided defender, they've gone Kelly back into his orthodox right-back position, and Andy Gray's come out as a right-winger.
And Dean is a waiver on the left, which is where he quite often does play, down that left flank, isn't he? But at the moment, it's Yorke battling away with Pemberton, with Milošević in some space inside. Still Dwight Yorke plays it for Milošević. And it'll go for the corner. Good play again by Dwight Yorke.
That's good defending, actually. That's the sort of defending they haven't really done. Because Milošević has opened himself out onto his left foot and has nearly given himself a very good chance.
Here comes a corner taken by Mark Draper. Too deep. Milošević challenging, but it'll be a Leeds throw. Draper, Dean, Berlin. He's picked out Kelly with a good ball here. Got out by Wright. Can Leatherall get there? Can. But now the break is on for Villa. Mark Draper leading it. Milošević is through the middle. He's told Draper where he wants it, but instead Draper's picked up Dwight Yorke. Still with Yorke, picks up Milošević, onto the left foot, and it's charged down again.
But it was the Leeds defence on the retreat again, backing off and backing off. I mean, I thought for a minute Yorke was going to take it through himself and have a pop.
McAllister. And now Gray. Licking the ball inside. Kelly's available to him. McAllister's got his head down and charging, and good play by Gareth Southgate.
There it is again, you see. The third defender getting across and covering the danger space quickly. Villa have worked, I mean, they've worked all season as a unit like this, whereas Leeds have only just started doing it.
Yeboah. McAllister, a little chip by him. Dean tries to get the hit, and Brolin almost got a foot on it. Howard Wilkinson will tell you that this man is very effective when he comes on as a substitute. They still doubt whether he's 100% fit to play effectively from the opening minute, but when he comes on as a sub, he has made a difference. Speed. Oh, badly dispossessed there by Dwight Yorke. Taylor's coming in to help him. So too is Gary Charles.
But they're queuing up. He had so many options then, Dwight, didn't he?
Here we are again, Ron.
Yeah, it's like pick a pass. Gary Charles is arriving. In fact, I thought he was a lot closer than that.
Yeah. It's fascinating stuff, really, because Leeds have got to take these sort of risks now, and it's opening up all sorts of possibilities at the other end for Aston Villa.
Well, I mean, Villa have thrived in this place, given them to them most of the game anyway, and, you know, it'll only get increasingly so, I think.
Townsend. Right. Draper. And now Southgate. hit long. Milosevic is charging after it. Weatherall should get there first, gets it back. Not an easy back pass for Lukic to deal with, but he deals with it comfortably in the end.
You see, it's just a straight ball over the top, and I mean, with all fairness to Milosevic, he likes the ball into feet. He doesn't really like to go off on runs. Just caused them untold problems there.
Comes out again to Gary Charles. It'll be a throw. Townsend. Over the top. Well, in fact, it's gone for a corner, surely.
No, it's offside. And he's really optimistic now, trying his hand from that distance. I mean, he's had a phenomenal game, I think, Townsend today. I think he has been an absolute captain. I mean, a lot of it was made of the confrontation about Gary McAllister and himself, and I think it's fair to say that at the moment, anyway, he's won it hands down.
Oh, Brolin, threading a ball through almost into the path of Yeboah. The odd little quiver coming from Leeds United, two down. Speed couldn't get on the end of that one. Pemberton held up Dwight Yorke there. Milosevic. Into Yorke. Into Townsend. Slip at the crucial moment. Andy Gray. To Thomas Brolin. Now for Gary Kelly. Brolin's gone away down the right for him. Gray again. Palmer. Space over there for speed. Moving towards McAllister. That'll come out now for Gray. Chip by him towards Yeboah. Good safe handling and good swift anticipation again by Mark Bosnich.
He loves that. He will love that.
He's handled well all afternoon.
Yeah, he likes that. Just lets want to get in amongst people. Love it.
They have had Milosevic.
I can't believe the problems Leeds have had with just a long ball down the middle. They've had untold problems with the kick.
McAllister almost forcing Townsend into the error. Palmer. That'll be a Leeds ball. Been a difficult game for the referees, handled it well though, there's not too much fuss. McAllister, Brolin, Lecchio gets it clear to Yorke, offside flag is up.
No, he's given a foul. It's a foul, you know. He's in his own half there, actually. I think he's just give Weatherall a little nudge as he went to gather it.
Must be, it's in that half of the field. Speed stopped by Charles. Been some good performances all around this Villa side. Gary Charles hasn't done much wrong, has he?
They haven't had a bad player. I mean, they've had it. You could virtually say they've had 10 outstanding players, or 10 outfield outstanding players. I think Bozzy hasn't had an awful lot to do. What he's done competently. But I mean, the number of times Townsend, Yorke, and Draper have put passes together has been untrue.
That was a nice little touch by Brolin. Yeboah couldn't quite pick it up from Palmer. That was hit a little too fiercely. McGrath. Taylor, scorer of the second goal. Leeds are backing off. Yorke is up alongside him. Palmer's coming back to attack him. And in the end, Leeds just look around and allow Dwight Yorke to pick it up again. He might be punished for this, no. McAllister's there. Hopping the ball up to Brolin. Southgate hits it straight at Kelly. And now Brolin. That's a foul. Free kick quickly taken. McAllister. Gray. to clear. Kerry. Long towards Dean, who was coming in on that far side. Heckled again got a valuable header in for Villa. Speed crossing it in again. Palmer's in there with a header. McGrath gets it clear. Leeds looking for a goal now to revive their hopes here. And again, Bosnich is there, anticipated it well, grabbed it high above the head, both of Yeboah and Dean. To beat Notts County and Derby, Blackburn, Reading and Birmingham in the semi-finals to get here. It's Palmer. No nonsense from Townsend. Villa got past Peterborough and Stockport, QPR, Wolves and the semi-final against Arsenal. That first semi-final when they were two goals down and struggling with the two goals by Dennis Bergkamp, who would have thought it would have finished this way, but they showed amazing powers of recovery, and that's exactly what Leeds have got to show now. There's the yellow card. Southgate, I think it was. It's a free kick, Leeds. Kelly with it. Bosnich coming again. Lost it. And McGrath gets it away. Leeds fans claiming there was a handball there, but they weren't really in the best position to see.
Always puzzles me why goalkeepers do that. I mean, there's a load of big guys in the box. There's a slow ball in. I don't think it's really necessary for Mark Bosnich to come and climb over the defenders.
Kelly's header. Dean has done well. Got speed alongside it, but he's not done well there. He's done appallingly. Now the clock will tell him that he's got about 12 minutes left to put this right.
Yeah, but where he'll be disappointed, Howard, he'll know his team hasn't done him justice today. He'll know that. I mean, they've come here and, you know, at least when you come to a final, you want your team to play it at its best, and they'll be the first to admit that they haven't done themselves justice. Having said that, I shouldn't detract Villa of being excellent.
No.
I mean, I wonder whether somebody like Andy Townsend would be able to keep the sort of tempo he's maintained all match, and he shows not one little bit of sign of flagging.
Given away there by speed. But Dwight Yorke couldn't make anything of it. The ricochet falls to Milošević. And now to Draper. Right. Milošević. And away goes Andy Gray. He's found Brolin. Brolin in turn trying to find Yeboah. But Yeboah has had no change whatsoever out of this back three of visitors this afternoon. And Southgate beats him quite comfortably there. That came off Draper, so it's going to be a Leeds throw. Palmer's gone well forward now. McAllister. Palmer's gone up and stayed up. Heckled with that clearance. And now the break is on again.
Yeah, but here's the danger now. They haven't got one midfield player back, and it's a spring against them. And there's York just pulling wide, looking up now, he's attacking the defender, as he's done for most of the day.
York with Milošević on this side. Taylor's come up quickly. Sorry, Ron.
Just saying, as he's done most of the afternoon, yes. He's been allowed to turn and go at them.
Taylor. Right. Dwight. Again, it's Draper. Taylor. Villa fans enjoying this. Southgate. So he wants to go all the way. Why not? But Palmer now can get the action springing to the other end. McAllister. Kelly. No. Southgate finds Draper. And Leeds had that hopeful spell early in the second half, but other than that...
Second goal's killed them, hasn't it?
Second goal has killed them, and Villa have looked the better side for most of the game.
Oh, they've murdered them.
Offside against York.
I actually think, Brian, it's been a classic Wembley performance.
By Villa, yes.
They've passed the ball excellently, one and two touch, they've fizzed it around. And to be fair to Leeds, Leeds haven't done themselves justice, but they've been chasing shadows for long periods where Villa haven't allowed them to get near the ball.
Kelly with a kick. Dean going for it. Corner given. So Leeds got a corner. They're calling up Gary Speed to take it. A little over 8 minutes left. Just imagine if Leeds were to nick one here now. They've got three players on the goal line. Here's the corner. Loaded in again. A safe pair of hands of Mark Bosnich.
It's incredible, isn't it? Whenever you play Leeds at Elland Road or whatever it stands, looks like Stoughton's going to get a little outing. Whenever you play Leeds at Elland Road, every dead ball, every set play, they send their big brigade up. You're always panicking for your life. And they haven't caused one threat today for them.
Yeboah chasing. Rolene supporting. McAllister's in there too, Rolene. Pemberton, long-range shot, no problem at all there. And there's no doubt that Steve Staunton will be coming on very shortly. Up goes Weatherall. Offside flag up against Milošević. Dean versus Ekiok. Come for Speed. Hits the ball in early towards Bray. I don't think Bosnich has been seriously troubled all afternoon, has he?
No, he's had the aerial stuff that he's trying to flutter out there, and everyone will flutter off the free kick there. There's been nothing where he's had to pull out anything world-class or anything.
Rolene beaten by Taylor. Taylor with a little ball forward. And Draper's on the way now, with Yorke on one side, and an offside flag goes up.
I think York is right there. I don't think he was offside, but the ball was heavy anyway. But it must be a lovely old feeling in a cup final to be ahead of the field at this stage. No, he looks just about onside there. But I mean, the ball was heavy anyway.
Yeah, two up with
two up, but enjoying yourself, yeah. Expressing yourself, and not really.
And not sensing you're in any trouble
that's
at all.
That's right. It's not really as if you think, oh, don't let them in.
That's
or
right.
You actually get the feeling that there's more in it for the Villa if they want it. I mean, they've passed the ball around now, but it's not been demonstration passing, it's been urgency. It's been a purpose to the passing. I mean, York's big thing, contribution to the season, of course, has been his goal scoring, but I'll bet he's not played a better game than he's played today.
Really?
Well, he's linked the play, he's shown for things, he's been a hell of a problem, and he's, you know, he's been in any number of outstanding performances.
Here's Kelly now for Leeds. McAllister. Space to measure up across. In fact, he's found Brian Dean. Dean tries to get it back to him. Needs a crossing now from Gray. Ricochets, almost nonchalantly kicked away or stabbed away there by Alan Wright in the first place, and then Draper. Offside flag goes up. Free kick to Aston Villa. Everton with that header for Charles. Here's speed again. Nice little touch there by Yeboah, and Palmer going through, and Brolin on the far side. Leeds making a late break here, and Palmer with a header, and he's just over. That was probably Leeds' best move of the game.
It was easily their best move of the game, Brian. Some great link-up play. Turns this back in, Brolin now. And Carlton Palmer just can't get over the top of the ball. That was their most incisive passing movement of the game.
Brolin played a big part in it, but here's Bosnich with a goal kick for Villa. Inside the last 3 minutes. Kelly. Up to Palmer, he let it go. Yeboah. Dean is there. Speed. That's going to be a corner. Alistair will take it. Leeds plastering that Villa area with white shirts now, including Weatherall back there. Held in, fisted away. Good piece of keeping. Gray. Knocked away by Southgate. Here's Milošević up here. If he can keep it running, and Yorke is up alongside him. No. Villa have now got to, rather, Leeds have got chance to get people back. Charles. Up to Dwight Yorke. Into Milošević. Yorke again to Townsend. To Yorke. To Wright. Palmer cut that out. Carlton Palmer. Fighting at Townsend for the ball and winning it. It's a nice little break, but in the end, heckled was there to hold up Brian Dean. Straight to Mark Draper. Oh, look at Milošević in a bit of space here. Pemberton trying to hold him up. If he gets it onto that left foot, it could be trouble. And it's Dwight Yorke! And it's another one! 3-0. Well, he's had a terrific season, Dwight Yorke, with those 22 goals. Those two vital ones in the semi-final. He's made them for Milošević, and now Milošević makes this one for him. 3-0, an emphatic finale now for Villa, and Milošević a big part of it.
You know, that can always happen when you're chasing the game, and the big spaces, they've worked it down the field. Milošević, very unselfish there, and that's a good finish, a nonchalant finish. A player on top of his game, doesn't hesitate, whack. And it's not a flattering score, is it?
It's not. No, it's a realistic scoreline, to be fair. Well, the smile that lights up football has lit up Aston Villa and their fans here at Wembley this afternoon. Dwight Yorke, leading scorer, his 23rd goal of the season. but neither Dwight, Yorke, nor Milošević, nor Taylor has been named man of the match for the Alan Hardacre Trophy. That goes to the man who's just played the ball there, the Aston Villa captain who's on the ball at the moment, Andy Townsend, and it couldn't be a better choice.
No, he's been absolutely magnificent, Andy. I mean, we all said at one stage it was going to be a confrontation of the international captains, and although he's received a lot more support by his teammates, he's deservedly did.
Played well, over a minute of time added on now. Villa certainly going to Europe next season. They're winners of this Coca-Cola Cup, there's no doubt about that now. With us, what Ron is saying, a classic Wembley performance. Their seventh appearance in the final, their fifth victory in this final in the League Cup, the Coca-Cola Cup, equaling the record of Liverpool. And here's Dwight Yorke, and maybe they're not finished yet. Yorke. Goal kick.
His appetite's been whetted now. He wants another one.
And Leeds are looking what they are, a beaten and at the moment looking a dispirited side. Up to Brolin. And here's Palmer. A bit of jockeying there from Gary Charles. Palmer's shot charged down by Paul McGrath. There goes the final whistle. The Coca-Cola Cup final has been won by Aston Villa. Howard Wilkinson congratulates Brian Little. And Savo Milošević, Dwight Yorke are amongst the scorers. Steve Staunton didn't get on in the end as a substitute. Ian Taylor, the other scorer. And Villa comfortable in the end, well-deserved winners after a classic Wembley Cup final performance. They dominated almost from beginning to end. Leeds had that little spell when Brian Dean came on at the start of the second half. But frankly, there was only ever going to be one winner, particularly from the moment after 20 minutes when Savo Milošević put that howitzer into the back of the Leeds United net. Well, big Hugo Ekiog. And let's go down and have a word with Ian Taylor.
Ian, congratulations. First of all, I mean, Aston Villa played so well this afternoon.
Yeah, we've been striving for it all season. I think we've played well all season, and this is just the icing on the cake, but we've still got, you know, we've still got a couple of games to go as well.
Yeah, we'll just concentrate on this one because you're the winners of the Coca-Cola Cup. Let's deal with your goal first of all. The first two goals were really excellent. What about your goal?
I can't remember much about it really. I just remember it coming out to me and I just lashed it with my left foot. And you know, it's not my good foot, but I thought I'd have a go. And it's just gone in the corner.
Now, 2 years ago, we can reveal, you were Aston Villa supporter really, because you were watching the Cup final when they beat, the Coca-Cola Cup final when they beat Manchester United, from the stands here.
Yeah, that's right. I've been a Villa fan all my life and you know, I was playing for Port Vale at the time and I thought I'd come to Wembley and watch the boys. But to be playing now and scoring the goal as well, it's phenomenal.
Well, what about the first goal? What a strike that was. Let's have your version first, Ian.
Savo, he stuck a bit of stick, but it's a great finish. He's got a great left foot and he's deserved it. He's kept battling on and icing on the cake for him.
Well, you have taken criticism, Savo, but it was a great goal.
Yeah, I think so. I mean, great game. We played tremendous tonight. We deserve to win.
And what a contrast for you for all the problems you've had at home.
Sorry?
All the problems you've had back at home. It's good for you today.
Yeah, great goal for me. I'm really happy. Thank you.
Quick word from you as Gary McAllister goes up there.
Yeah.
You scored. Took you a long while.
No, it's just the result, really. We needed to win, actually. It's been a tremendous season for us all season.
and it would have been hard for us not to come here and get beat today.
Okay, thank you, Dwight.
Well, the Leeds United players, it's the tradition here for the Coca-Cola Cup final is that the losers go up first. Jaberg gets his loser's medal from Virginia Bottomley. Guest of honour today. There isn't much she can say to them, and there isn't much they want to say either, to be honest. They battle hard enough. That's a bit of a cliche, of course, but they were... They probably know better than anybody that they were well beaten on the day, and there's no doubting that. Villa took their goals superbly, but overall their team pattern was excellent. As John Barnes was saying at half-time, they attack as a team and they defend as a team, and there hardly seemed to be a weakness anywhere. 11 perfect heroes out there wearing Aston Villa shirts today. So they've equaled Liverpool's record of 5 victories in this tournament. The money generated by this cup run runs into millions, and now, of course, as I say, there's the big money-spinning prospect of a place in the UEFA Cup for Aston Villa next season. As Andy Townsend goes up, well, he's covered just about every blade of grass at Wembley this afternoon. Why not those 39 so steps that take him up to the Royal Box now? A great captain who's done a terrific job, and at the end, a worthy result, a victory. It's a heavy cup, but he's strong enough to take it. A sight for all Villa fans. In the meantime are going off the pitch. There's not really a lap of honour for them, really. Doug Ellis, the Villa chairman, in the cap there. Mark Bosnich, who's handling right through the afternoon, was first class. Paul McGrath, who they tell you has probably been their best defender, particularly over the last few weeks, never put a foot wrong. Man who scored the second goal, Mark Draper, who made those fantastic runs from the midfield, where Villa really dominated. And Gareth Southgate, so cool and dependable at the back. Alan Wright and Gary Charles, the two fullbacks who went bombing down the wings. And here's the man, just 22 years old, who's taken so much stick and has faced it all with a smile and still gone on chasing the ball. But his just rewards today with that opening goal, which was absolutely superb. Dwight Yorke has been scoring all season and has saved a special one for Wembley as well. The substitutes come on as well. Young Michael Oakes, the reserve goalkeeper, and Tommy Johnson and Steve Staunton too. Let's have a word with Andy Townsend, the man of the match.
Congratulations, Andy. You deserve the man of the match. You personally played well, and so did the team this afternoon. What was your view of it?
Well, I'm not sure about me winning this, Gary, to be honest.
Oh, you had a great game, Andy.
The team just played very well. You know, we were really up for this match, very relaxed. You know, and full credit to the lads, because we played well all season. And, you know, we sort of just slipped away in the league last few weeks. And there's always a danger the whole thing can fizzle out. But credit to the boys, they kept at it and deserved it today.
Now, let's deal with Milošević, who's taken a lot of criticism. But all you guys have stuck with him, and he's scored a terrific, important first goal.
Well, because, you know, I've said all along, he's a bit of an easy target. You know, he's a young lad, he doesn't speak the language very well. He's an easy one to look at that. How about that?
That's yeah, that's the goal.
You know, but he's played his part today. Fabulous goal. Funnily enough, we all had a feeling he would do that today. Absolutely chuffed him.
Now, finally, what has been the big difference with Villa from last season to this season?
Well, I just think confidence, Gary. You know, we've obviously got different players, confidence, and we're just, you know, on a bit of a roll.
Thanks, Andy. Well done.
Welcome back to Wembley Stadium, some 10 minutes after Aston Villa have won the Coca-Cola Cup final, deservedly 3-0 winners against Leeds United. Let's hear from the Villa manager, Brian Little. He's with Gary Newbold.
Brian, congratulations, you're having a marvellous season, but this is at last some actual success for you.
Yeah, delighted. I mean, it couldn't really have gone any better, I don't think. We actually got frustrated the last 15 minutes because we had a spell where we thought we could have gone 3-0 and the game would have been finished, but it's been a great day out. And it is a day out when you win here at Wembley, so we're all delighted.
You deserve to win today as well.
Yeah, I mean, we stepped it up second half. They started the first 5 minutes brightly, but then we became the better side and won comfortably in the end.
Well done, Brian.
Yes, indeed, well done, Brian. Well done, Villa. And very deserving winners, John Barnes, weren't they?
Played excellently today, very well. A bit disappointed in Leeds, but Villa thoroughly deserved their victory.
Yeah, well, you were both right. I was the one that was wrong. I had a sneaky suspicion for Leeds.
You're a goalkeeper,
but...
Bob.
Yeah.
You're a goalkeeper.
I know. Well, it just shows you don't believe goalkeepers. Let's have a look at the Ian Taylor goal. There was a question mark, I guess, about my old pal Lukey here on the cross, John Lukey.
I thought John Lukey might have come and gotten this, actually, but he's decided it there not to go. And it was just an unfortunate clearance that dropped very, very nicely for Taylor, who rifled it into the net. And it was, he had room to do it. But then again, Villa always had room to do it, whatever they wanted to do in the game.
The Villa players were the first onto the ball, and if you can just see the shot when he actually pushed the ball in, there was a Leeds midfield player on the wrong side of him. I think it was Carlton Palmer, and really he's just got a free shot there with him behind him. And that happened all day. They were going beyond the Leeds midfield.
We started with that sunny smile of the guy from Tobago, from Dwight, Yorke, and he finished the game with an even bigger smile, didn't he?
Yeah, a wonderful strike by Dwight. They had room all the two, Milošević and Yorke had room to run at the defenders all day, and as you see, they're overcommitted and left Yorke by himself. You see, they've got four defenders in the box against two, and they've not marked either of them.
But when that move started, there were four defenders, and not one of them went to Milošević early enough. I mean, it was just a case of letting him settle on the ball, let him dictate to them where he's going to put it, and then he's just rolled a ball back for Dwight Yorke, and he's thumped it at the top of the net. And you've still got people around there who weren't marking or picking up. I mean,
people very quickly...
The Leeds back four have had a bad day.
Yeah, they had a bad day, Jack, and people very quickly, they forget the losers. But let's have one little ray of hope for your old club. The young boy who continues the Grey dynasty, he's following Dad Frank and Uncle Eddie, isn't he?
He's done two beautiful things down the left-hand side here. Good skill, good at them. He's sent Paul McGrath the wrong way, and he's hit it with his right foot. It's not the place to play a ball there from that sort of an angle. I mean, you've either got to whap it across the goals so that if the goalkeeper gets a hand to it, somebody's got a chance to knock it in. Mm. But he had done that twice, actually, in the game. He pulls it onto his right foot and then put it into the bottom corner.
But at least Andy Gray won to look for
in the second half, he had more room in the first 10 minutes because he played up front in the first half, didn't get much room, played out wide before, and then the second half, when Brian Dean came on, that gave him more room to get the ball and do that. I think that is all easy in hindsight, but I'm sure, you know, had he started out there, he could have caused him more problems.
OK, can I remind you that you have to play Aston Villa next Sunday in the FA Cup, Liverpool, John?
Yeah, Aston Villa have been one of my favourite teams all season. Even when we actually beat them 2-0 at Villa Park and 3-0 at home, they played really well, particularly down there. So, I don't know whether it's a good thing that they've actually won. Maybe they'll be in Europe next year so they're relaxed, but maybe with already having one trophy
under
their belt.
That's what you hope.
That's what I hope. But with maybe one trophy under their belt, they can go out and play the type of football that you saw here today, which really we don't want. Yeah. We want them to be in a nice, relaxed atmosphere. So let's hope they celebrate all week.
Now, Jim Rosenthal, that's the disappointed Leeds manager, Howard Wilkinson, with him.
Yes, Howard, there's no sadder place than the loser's dressing room. Your team didn't do Leeds or yourself justice today.
No, no one likes to come to Wembley and lose. But Villa deserved what they got today. Played very well, and really we didn't cause them problems at all. In fact, most of the time we caused ourselves problems. First goal and the last goal, square balls across the middle of the park. But we just didn't perform.
Briefly, a bitter personal disappointment as well, Howard.
Yeah, they say what a memorable day. They say enjoy it. They say it doesn't last forever. It goes very quickly. None of those things happened today. It went very, very slowly. I didn't enjoy it, but it was memorable.
Thanks for coming out and facing the music, Howard.
Thank you very much, Jim. Thank you.
Yeah.